When we hear AI, the first thing that comes to our mind are usually words like robots, self-driving cars, or supercomputers solving complex data. In reality, we can relate to a lot of things on Earth that are using artificial intelligence like smartwatches, Alexa, Siri, Google, Netflix, and many more. But to get AI into space and satellites has always been a struggle and very expensive, but not anymore. Let's see how. Usually, space machines and satellites use special radiation hardened chips that are custom made for the space environment, which is at least few decades behind the modern technology and processing capabilities on Earth. But now, Intel, along with ESA, which is a European space agency, in partnership with Irish robotics company Eurica, along with Dutch company Cosine, and other partners, have successfully launched VSAT-1, a cube satellite that uses AI for Earth observation. In short, it's an AI satellite. And if you're wondering what a cube satellite is, it's a type of nanosatellite which is in the classification of satellites that weighs between 1 to 10 kg and has smaller dimensions like that of a shoebox or a bit bigger in size. More than 1,000 nanosatellites have been successfully deployed in orbit already, with most launches happening in the last decade. By the way, let's not think that small satellites are going to do smaller jobs. These are much more powerful and can do a lot of operations from orbit using AI. As we have seen how the size of computers evolved from the size occupying a full room to a size of a palm, even satellites are evolving and getting smaller and more efficient. Now coming back to the AI satellite VSAT-1, its onboard processing is done using Intel's Movidius MirrorEye 2 VPU, a $99 chip that is commonly seen in some smartphones, drones, and AI headsets. Although this is not among the most powerful processors on Earth right now, this chip from Intel Movidius turned out to be a much cheaper option and was able to withstand all tests for space conditions, including very harsh radiations. This is the very first time that a commercially available chip that has been used for smart devices was modified and programmed to be used as an AI chip for satellite use. This is considered as an achievement, as normal commercial chips that are commonly used in devices on Earth will show high processing error rates in space and can catch fire if not modified and protected well. In any case, mission of this AI satellite is to monitor Earth for polar ice and soil moisture, along with testing Intel satellite communication systems, with an idea to create a future joint network of satellites. It uses artificially programmed neural networks to process the image data, which helps in reducing camera bandwidth by 60% and making it cheaper to produce. All images that are covered by clouds and that are not usable or of low quality are automatically discarded by the AI algorithm. Remember that 70% of our planet's surface is covered by clouds at any given time. So this reduces the number of satellite images that need to be downloaded from space, and thus saving valuable time for scientists on Earth and increasing efficiency as large amounts of images is clicked and transferred to ground stations each day. According to the European Space Agency, satellites can deliver more than 150 terabytes of data per day. So, using technologies like AI in space would reduce cost, extend battery life of satellites, and help in producing higher quality of satellite image data. Anyway, what all this means is that future of AI in space can be more affordable and efficient by using low-cost cube satellites and commercially available AI chips. These types of smaller satellites with AI will roughly cost about $100,000 to launch and design, as compared to a bigger commercial satellite that needs millions of dollars. Soon we'll be seeing the total average cost of such satellites to be around $50,000 or even less, but with much more powerful AI processors and cameras. ESA and other partners are already working on the next version of satellite VSAT-2, which will have more AI applications for collecting, distributing, and studying satellite image data. Some of these applications will be to transform satellite images into a street map, autonomous detection and classification of maritime vessels, monitoring forests and other natural resources. I'll be releasing a separate video explaining more about possible applications of AI on Earth observation satellites and satellite imagery data. I'm sure in the next 10 years' time, we'll see a lot of advancements in Earth observation and space exploration due to technologies such as AI. Space and the world beyond are very complex and far from our imaginations. We need systems like AI to monitor and study all about our planet and to explore further into other similar planets. Let's wait and see what happens and how fast these technologies will develop. So comment below your thoughts on AI satellites and what AI satellites can probably do in the future. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video and gained some new piece of information. If yes, hit that subscribe button now, like the video and share with your friends. I'll be coming up with more videos related to satellite technologies, artificial intelligence, computers and many more. Take care and see you again. Bye.